I'm Tyler Thompson, the project lead for Torchlight Frontiers at Echtra Games.
Tyler, talk about what Torchlight Frontiers is.
Torchlight Frontiers is the online version of Torchlight. It's all the flavor, feel, and fun of Torchlight in an online game.
So talk about what your team learned from Torchlight that you were able to apply, because that was one of the major criticisms of the game. It's like, we want to go online, we want co-op, we want online play.
Absolutely. So it's both this marriage of taking all the cool things that we love about Torchlight and almost always assuming that we're going to do it the Torchlight way, unless we have a great argument for not doing that. And then making an online game, a service that we'll keep adding to, content that we'll keep adding, and a place that you'll meet other players and play together with them.
So talk about what are some of the challenges when taking a single player dungeon crawler and making that online?
So there's a few things. There's trying to find good ways to make sure that players have a place to play together. And in that place, kind of the challenge is that usually in an action RPG, you're used to fighting your way through a dungeon, clearing it all the way to the end and exploring to the exits. But when you have a shared space, when you're trying to play together with other players, we need monsters to respawn. We need the space to be something you know how to navigate through. And this has introduced a lot of challenges for us figuring out how to do those monster respawns to feel good, make sure everything's instanced properly so no one's stealing that treasure chest from you, and things like that. And all that has kind of led to what we have today.
The important thing is everything in the original Torchlight, like the mini games and stuff like fishing, will those be in Torchlight Frontiers? Because you got placement in our top 10 mini fishing games, by the way.
Fishing is one of the things our Discord group loves to talk about. It's something we definitely see as a part of what people like about Torchlight. We have not added it to the game yet, so I can't really officially say whether it's in or out, but it's definitely something we know people are looking for.
When you make an online game, the point of that is it's ever evolving, right?
Absolutely. Like, one of the things we like to say that in the fullness of time, we'll be able to get to that. So it's kind of more, oftentimes the answer is less about whether we're going to do something, but when we'll be doing it.
All the classes in the original Torchlight make a return, as well as new abilities and classes?
We actually rethought and created a whole new set of classes. We've announced two of them here. The big thing to realize about Torchlight classes is that they're not kind of the middle of the dartboard. They're not your wizards and warriors. They're always something a little funky and a little bit different. So the two that we were showing here at the demo is a Dusk Mage, which balances light and dark magic together and to make himself more powerful or herself more powerful, and the Forge, which is a big robot with a chest cannon that pops out and shoots monsters.
Now, I'd be remiss if I didn't mention the Nintendo Switch. Diablo 3 just got announced for that. Do you guys have plans for that platform at all?
You know, we've been getting asked that a lot at the show. Everyone's both excited personally because they love to play on the Switch and just because of Diablo 3's announcement. We have not decided on what we're going to do there, and we're still in discussions about it, but we are based on Unreal Engine 4, so it's not a massive technical challenge for us. Yes, where we're going to put our efforts and when we would do it.
Are you guys planning for console release as well?
Absolutely. So we're planning to have PC in 2019 and then consoles pretty soon thereafter.
So how much groundwork was already done for you for Torchlight and Torchlight 2 that you were able to take in put it in Torchlight Frontiers?
There's no actual like assets or technology that we've used directly, but there's a whole lot of great gameplay systems and feel that those games have. And so things like pets as being a major part of what you collect and use and find and your companion for you throughout the game, having them collect and hold items, have them go back to town to sell them. That whole concept of thing is just something that's so Torchlight, and it's just a great thing to be able to bring to this game.
So what you're telling me is from the ground up, basically.
Yeah, from the ground up, we've been making this as a Torchlight game. In fact, when we were working on it, we've been working on it for 2.5 years. All along the way, we were meeting with Runic. We even had some of the artists doing animations, background art, concept art, UI, and participating with us as they were wrapping up Hob. This is a Torchlight game through and through.
You guys have a potential release date yet?
Sometime in 2019.
So next year.
This is an online game, so it's something that we'll be growing our audience as we go from closed beta and alpha to becoming an open beta, gradually increasing the number of people are playing, and eventually just pull that beta off the icon and say we're done.